Hello and welcome to the session. In this session we will discuss ratios. When we need to compare two quantities, we use ratios. We know that the ratio for two different comparisons may be the same, and when we need to compare two quantities, the units must be the same. Suppose that we need to find the ratio of 3 meters to 20 centimeters. Now as you can see that the units of both these quantities are different. One is in meters and the other in centimeters. First we need to convert both the units to the same unit. That is, we have 3 meters is equal to 3 into 100 centimeters. That is 300 centimeters. Thus we have the required ratio, that is 3 meters is to 20 centimeters, is given as 300 is to 20, which is equal to 15 is to 1. So the ratio of 3 meter to 20 centimeter is 15 is to 1. Next is equivalent ratios. Different ratios can be compared with each other to know whether they are equivalent or not. For this, what we do is, we first convert the given ratios in the form of fractions. Then, these fractions are converted to like fractions. And if we get that the like fractions are equal, then the given ratios are equivalent ratios. Consider the ratios 5 is to 20 and 3 is to 12. Let's see if these two ratios are equivalent or not. First we have the ratio 5 is to 20. We convert this into fractions, so we have 5 upon 20. Then the ratio 3 is to 12 is written as 3 upon 12. Now we need to convert them to like fractions. So for that, we multiply both the numerator and denominator of this fraction by 3. So we get 15 upon 60. And here we multiply the numerator and denominator by 5. So as to get 15 upon 60. Now as you can see that the like fractions that we have obtained are equal. So we say that the ratios 5 is to 20 and 3 is to 12 are equivalent ratios. Now let's consider the ratios 1 is to 6 and 1 is to 4. Let's see if they are equivalent or not. Now 1 is to 6 is written as 1 upon 6. 1 is to 4 is written as 1 upon 4. Now we convert them to like fractions. For that, we multiply both the numerator and denominator of this fraction by 4. So we get 4 upon 24. And here we multiply both the numerator and denominator by 6. So we get 6 upon 24. Now as you can see that these like fractions are not equal. So we have that 4 upon 24 is less than 6 upon 24. Or you can say that 1 upon 6 is less than 1 upon 4, and thus the two ratios 1 is to 6 and 1 is to 4 are not equivalent. Then we have, if the two ratios are equivalent, then the four quantities are said to be in proportion. Like as you can see, in this example, the ratio 5 is to 20 and 3 is to 12 are equivalent. So we say that 5, 20, 3 and 12 are in proportion. Next we discuss keeping things in proportion and getting solutions. Suppose that we have some apples with us and we have that the cost of 2 kg of apples is rupees 20. Then we need to find the cost of 5 kg of apples. This can be done in two ways. First, we assume that the cost of 5 kg of apples is rupees X. Now we consider the proportions. That is, we have 2 is to 20 is equal to 5 is to X. That is, 2 upon 20 is equal to 5 upon X. So from here we get X is equal to 20 into 5 upon 2. So this gives us 50. That is, we get that the cost of 5 kg apples is rupees 50. Now the other method of doing this is by using unitary method. In the unitary method, we first find the value of 1 unit and then the value of the required number of units. Like as we are given that the cost of 2 kg apples is rupees 20. So first we find out the cost of 1 kg apples, which would be equal to rupees 20 upon 2, that is equal to rupees 10. Now we find out the cost of 5 kg of apples, which would be equal to rupees 10 into 5, and that is equal to rupees 50. So the cost of 5 kg of apples is rupees 50. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of ratios.